guys. Welcome back to the SourceFed podcast here on SourceFed YouTube channel, SoundCloud, iTunes. You know the works. Today I'm here with the beautiful Raina Scully.
You were going at me with that one. I was like, thank you, Sam. I was honored.
Hey, I'm here with the beautiful William Haynes. He's looking great today.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
And the beautiful Seychelle Gabriel. Thank you for coming on with us today.
And the beautiful Sam Basher.
Thank you.
And before we get into this, I keep telling you guys, when we have guests, we don't always have Fiji water. They never give me Fiji water.
This is always what we get.
Like, we try to put on airs like, oh, well, we care about the host throats. No, they don't.
No, we get tap
water. They care
water.
When you're here. They don't.
But guys, if you want to listen to this or watch this however you want to do, we're on the YouTube channel, sourcefed.com. You know, check us out there. But you should check us out on iTunes, just search SourceFed Podcast, or on SoundCloud, SourceFed Podcast. Also, make sure you resubscribe if you got unsubscribed because the RSS feeds got all mixed up. Just make sure you resubscribe on iTunes and SoundCloud. And today, our episode is brought to you by Crunchyroll. Oh, isn't that right? Cool.
Yes, it is. If you are big anime fans like we are, head on over to crunchyroll.com/SFPodcast for your 30-day free trial. Ooh. That means you can watch hit shows like Attack on Titan, Naruto Shippuden, and Baby Steps, which is the anime I'm translating currently, for free. On top of that, if you want to step up your game, you can upgrade to premium, and then you can watch everything ad-free, and you get to watch simulcast episodes, which means they get broadcast in Japan, and an hour later, they get broadcast here.
Now say some Japanese stuff.
This is intense.
Onegai desu, mite kudasai. Sugoku ganbatteru no de, yoroshiku onegai shimasu.
Now say it backwards.
Sumashika.
That's good enough.
Oh, God, that was hard. I got really red.
I only speak English.
How's everybody's day today? Let's start off with simple. How is everybody's day today?
It's pretty great. Mellow. I mean, I like
yellow.
Today.
Mellow yellow.
I did too many things today. I have never spoken this much in my entire life.
Today is that day.
Absolutely, yeah. I made every... Okay, so people who watch the channel, everything you see for the next 2 weeks after today, I did it all today. Every time you say it, I did it all today. I'm like literally shaking from like I am too. Yeah, I did too much today.
What? Mm-hmm. Wait, I am too.
Hey, look at us.
Why are we shaking today?
I did nothing today.
Poor Seychelle.
I did nothing.
Oh,
I mean,
man.
I ate food. And
that must be great.
I read. Yeah, it was great.
I bought a book this weekend, and I was like, oh, I'm going to read this. I opened it like twice.
Oh, I'm proud of you. That was twice.
It was a George Carlin book. He got too aggressive.
Oh, the ones by the toilet?
Yeah, the ones by our toilet.
The ones by our toilet.
That's fantastic. Yeah. Wait, it's too intense?
No, I just didn't feel like reading that.
I get it.
I feel like going on Instagram when I'm in the bathroom.
That's solid.
I mean,
that's true.
Yeah, I feel the same way.
Yeah, I mean,
somebody just sent me the Avatar comic? Is that the appropriate way to say it?
Gosh,
is it manga or comic?
No, it's definitely a comic.
Oh, it's a comic book.
Yeah,
okay.
That's awesome.
It's real
It's
good.
Intense, isn't it?
Yeah, it's real sad, too.
It's sad.
Making me nostalgic.
Oh, no. Do you know anything about those?
No.
Yeah, the comic books are real good. They like to continue the story from Avatar. Oh, I'm a nerd.
After the first series?
Yes.
Can I say shit today?
I didn't know.
I can say shit right now, right?
Yeah, you're good.
Okay,
yeah.
You already did. Tell us about do the nerdy shit now, Sam.
Do the nerdy shit.
It's really good. No, it continues on past like the end of the Avatar Last Airbender series.
I had no idea that. Thank you. It's really cool.
And everybody tweets at us with it, and I've never picked it up, and now I finally did.
I want to say, okay, there's this image on the internet of there's an Appa doll, and they tie balloons to it.
Yeah, oh, I love that.
I have been sent that 10 million times.
Yeah.
I appreciate it so much.
I do, too.
That's been happening since last year.
Yeah. Since last year.
I know.
Every day.
Have you seen this? Yes.
Everyone knows we're huge fans. That's why. They're being really sweet.
I had to stop being a fan. It was interrupting my life. I thought about that stuff too much. Too much. I had to stop. I had to stop.
You're a big anime fan, huh?
I had to stop. I haven't... Anime will ruin your life. You know why?
Yeah.
Because the sites like Crunchyroll, they're like, you can watch this anytime.
Ad-free.
We won't stop you.
Yeah.
No advertising.
We won't stop you. Actually, please do. Keep watching.
No, don't stop. Please don't stop.
I've seen over 350 episodes of One Piece. I've called my mom like twice in the past month.
Sad, bro.
It's too. I mean, but you know, she's not gonna tell me about what's going on in the pirate world. And so.
Do you guys have a favorite anime? I know you guys have, but have you ever watched anime? Or do you
have
a favorite?
I have not, which is.
Oh,
we're gonna convert you
to.
No, I am already.
It's
converting.
Gonna change.
I'm in the process.
Yeah. I'm really proud to be doing that. It's like an honor. You know, we're gonna introduce you to the anime world.
It's like for stoners, are like, let me give you your first
hit. Yeah, this is a gateway.
this is a gateway drug. Next thing you're gonna be the sweaty one at the conventions.
That's
and
amazing.
Like.
Hey!
I already smell.
Please tell me favorite ones so I know
favorite
what to watch.
Ones? Well, yeah. I love Parasite. Parasite was Really,
that one
really
scares
good.
Me.
No, it's really well made, and I think it's made by the same director that did Death Note, I believe. Oh, no, that might be wrong. Actually, I might be wrong on that one. Sorry about that. I might be mixing Attack on Titan with all that. But Parasite is fantastic. It's one stint.
All right. Parasite is a show. It's an animated. Okay. It's an anime about a guy.
I'm the audience.
Yeah. There's always the character in the movie that they explain to. Parasite is anime about a regular kid, regular guy in high school who's like.
Kind of nerdy.
Extra regular. So he's kind of nerdy.
Yeah.
And then one day he falls asleep, and then an alien comes down from space and bites his hand off, and then his hand is an alien now. And it's kind of...
It's really... It's
and
creepy.
And it's not just the alien.
Or a bad alien.
A bad alien.
No,
bad.
No, no,
this
don't
show could have been so funny.
No, it's not really bad. Listen, they're not actually bad.
Spoilers.
It's a philosophical anime.
Oh.
Okay? So it's supposed to be like, what is the next generation
of creatures?
I don't
like to think that much when I watch TV. I'm going to be honest.
Okay, so we could tone it down and watch One Piece instead.
One Piece is so
One Piece?
Simple.
One Piece is action. It's pirates, baby.
It's about a guy who's not a regular guy who wants to be the king of the pirates.
He was regular until he ate the fruit.
Gumu fruit. Yes. The gum. Okay, look, you're taking me into parts of my brain I tried to let go for a minute. I love anime. But
anime won't let
so
you go.
Tell us about you. What you got
yeah,
going on right now?
What kind of
right
stuff
now?
Are you what interested are you in so we can maybe like direct it
oh
better?
Oh, God. What am I interested in? That's related
tough
to this?
Just in your life. I want to know what's going on in your life.
We'll cater to you.
I have lately been getting back into blues music,
blues
which
music
I really got into in high school.
Oh.
You're so damn cool.
I mean, I don't know.
So interesting.
I just really connect to it. I've been going back and I'm working on this film. Well, I just finished it. It's a little independent film called Slight.
Mm-hmm.
Plug.
go check out Slight on DVD.
It's awesome. But on set, someone gave me, we're talking about Spike Lee and talking about our favorite movies, and we're talking about Mo Betta Blues, which is an awesome movie, and I didn't have it, and he came to set the next day with a copy for me. I was like, oh my gosh, thank you.
Oh, that's cool.
I need to give you something. I don't have anything. He's like, why don't you make me a mix of your favorite blues music? And I was like, yeah, but I'd never done that before, and it was so therapeutic
mm-hmm.
and wonderful. It's
just
like
making a playlist?
Yeah, like your favorite songs, and it's just such a wonderful activity, even if it's just any genre.
I like really aggressive music.
No, you don't.
Oh, yeah, I see,
do
I used
you?
To not. Now you went away
it's
for
like
a while.
It's like a duality thing. You like you are really into aggressive stuff, but you also like your jazz.
I love jazz music,
what?
And I just, and no one in particular. I just like to put on jazz music because my aggressive music makes me too mad.
What kind of aggressive are we talking?
I'm talking about Kanye West.
That's amazing.
You think an early Kanye West, like, good morning, ooh, I'm talking about stubble and like, I'm talking about mad Kanye West.
Yeah.
I love that. Oh, my God. And blues is kind of opposite of that.
A little.
Blues is kind of a rebellion, though. I mean, it was people that were suffering. I mean, it's music coming out of that, you know,
mm-hmm.
that people who were oppressed and stuff. I mean, it's pretty intense in a lot of the messages, I guess, and
yeah.
Kanye's new album, I think, relate to that a lot.
It does.
But which
Kanye
is cool.
Is so deep.
Like Blood on the Leaves.
Blood
yeah,
on the Leaves. I see my blood on the leaves. I see the blood on the leaves. They say that we the new slaves. I see the blood on the leaves. Oh, God, I love it.
It's important that he's
that wasn't
like,
terrifying
you know,
at all for us.
He plays it every day.
I play it every day. Before I film a video, like when I'm doing one of my big videos, I put on my Kanye West playlist, Funye, and I get hyped. And I get mad.
Yes,
it's called Funye. People always think
that's
weird.
The most
weird.
He also has Fun Bino.
Oh,
Gambino. I thought you were off Gambino.
I had to. He got too sad. I was like, this is making me sad. Music makes you feel. Do you feel sad when you listen to blues music?
Yeah.
Do you feel soul?
Yeah. Yes, I do. Someone
really
gave me
cool.
a song. Oh, he introduced me more to Tom Waits, which I hadn't listened
oh.
to that much.
Oh,
crazy.
What?
Okay,
why?
He has songs that break your heart like in 7 million pieces. Mm. And you're just sitting there in silence by yourself. Like, I don't know who
yeah.
I am.
I
sounds
seen
like
a couple,
good time.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
I've seen a couple clips of him on YouTube where he just goes on stage and he's just like, he expresses himself, right? He expresses
like
himself.
Like
uncensored videos,
yeah.
really.
He says whatever he wants, you know, does and makes weird music, and I dig it. I dig anybody like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're like breaking down walls. I don't know how to
yeah.
describe
breaking
it.
Down
yeah,
walls,
are they breaking down walls.
Shit.
Yeah.
Soul.
Yeah. Do you play?
I play a little guitar, a little harmonica. I
oh,
sing
cool.
mostly.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
you
so
sing
cool.
too?
You sing
that's
and
not on your
you
Wikipedia page, which I read a lot.
I
or your IMDb.
It's on my Twitter, kind of. I don't know. I sing. I sang. I was more into singing before I was into acting.
Oh my God.
I have seen that. Okay, I didn't need to admit
that's creepy.
That.
Yeah,
that's okay.
You could just have been surprised.
Okay.
Let's
really cool.
be honest.
Like 12 times, all right? All right?
I creep on people all the time.
Is there anything wrong with
time.
It?
Just, yeah.
The people I creep on, I usually don't meet. Usually.
And you usually don't tell
usually.
Them that you're creeping
on
them.
That's weird. Mm-hmm. Not saying that this
like
is
now?
Weird because I don't feel weird, but like that when you meet someone and you're
so
like
nice.
Pretending that you don't know them. Have you done that? Have you experienced? Okay. Am I
absolutely.
Weird one here? Yeah.
So you know, like.
I have lied many times. Oh, hi. Like, I've
never
totally
met
you know
before.
That you love red wine and puppies. Like,
yeah,
you have to lie.
You can know so many things about people now without ever meeting them.
Is that still now creepy now that there's like a paradigm shift?
Like, it depends on how specific you get. If you're really specific, it's like, hey, you like this movie. Mm-hmm. Like, that's okay. But you're like, oh, I know what time you watched this movie. Remember when you watched it, like, because on Twitter now, because we're all like, exposed.
Yeah, yeah.
There was one time somebody at a convention was like, oh my God, I love this movie. I remember you watched it with your ex. And I was like, oh, you got too specific. Oh, you got too specific.
Oh my God, they dug.
Right, yeah.
They dug for that.
But they did, but then they like backed up. They were like, I'm so sorry. And I was like, it's okay.
You know what
I
sometimes
subconscious,
don't like?
Like they wanted you.
Yeah.
On Instagram, sometimes when I get updates, somebody will like a photo from like 160 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And I'm like,
that's weird.
Yeah. What were you doing?
How
were they doing?
How? Yeah. Why that one?
And I know that Sam is particularly. Sam likes his privacy. Sam likes to go home and be himself. Mm. And I know Darren and I knew that. And like 2 years ago, we went on Sam's Tumblr and like, you know, you can ask anonymous questions. And we were like, we just saw your gray, whatever old car you used to have right outside of the.
It was not funny because there
was
a person who was.
It was hilarious.
Yeah, it was hilarious to you.
That would scare me.
People following me don't like it.
Yeah, that's scary.
Yeah. You guys are mean friends.
I know. It's not even really friends, really.
Huh?
That's not a friend thing to do.
No.
That's like
it's like a bully thing to do.
Yeah.
Oh.
And honestly, if I hadn't told you I did it, I probably would have done it a couple more times. Just
and I wouldn't have known.
And you wouldn't
have known.
You would have never known.
Wow. That's wrong.
I think I'm due for a prank back from you.
Oh,
it's
no,
been
no.
2 years.
I'll get you. I'm planning. I'm scheming.
I don't like getting
that's
money.
That's scary, too.
Huh? I don't like being given money.
Okay.
So, you know.
Damn. Okay.
Get creative.
That wrapped it up nicely. Okay, so you like blues and music and a little bit of sad stuff. I have a fantastic anime for you.
I love sad stuff.
Your Lie in April.
Oh, it's so good.
And it's so about music.
Wait, what is it called?
It's called Your Lie in April.
Your Lie, as in you're telling a lie?
You told a lie. Yeah, like you told a
lie. In April.
Yeah.
In the month of April?
That's
yes.
This is a show.
You told
this
a
is
lie
a show. It's an animated
April.
Show.
It's phenomenal. It's probably a masterpiece, honestly. It's made by Madhouse.
When was it made?
Last year, late 2014.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's phenomenal. It's about music. It's about classical music, but it might be up your alley. It's got a really nice sad tone to it. That
it
sounds
makes,
weird, but it's a nice sad
it
tone.
It's,
can't tell you. It's going to spoil everything.
I'm going to tell you anyway. It's about a little boy. He plays piano, and he's like a genius. And he's like, I don't want to play piano anymore. Because, you know, if you didn't have a, I don't know, I don't want to do it anymore, it wouldn't be a movie. It'd just be like real life. People all in real life all the time are like, I don't want to do anything. And then some stuff happens.
Hey, okay, that's, oh, man,
wow,
that is so incorrect.
Really interesting. It sounds great.
He stops playing piano for a very, very specific traumatic reason, but he has to start up again for another better reason.
To save
and it's
the
a
world.
It's a girl. It's a girl.
It's
a girl.
It's a girl. It's a girl.
It's always a girl.
I know, but that's real life.
How old is he?
He's like 16. He's like 16.
They're like middle school into high school kind of area.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's nice. It's great.
Yeah. Well, you're missing out on a whole bunch out there.
I know. That's why I'm here. I didn't come here to
what's it like doing?
I came here to learn about anime.
What's it like doing voice acting?
I have only worked on Korra, and it was really fun, also intimidating, because I didn't get into voice acting to be a voice. I, you know, kind of got into it through live action acting.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So auditioning for it, I remember I went for I was on YouTube, Googling the guy who did Bugs Bunny's voice, and I was just going through the history
You're
of things.
You're
stalking
him, too.
Yeah, I was just learning about all this stuff I'd never seen, or I mean, I don't know, learned about before. But it's fun. I was working with a lot of pros who did a lot of characters who were so funny just on their own. Like PJ, who plays Bolin.
Oh.
First
man.
Of all, nicest
Chills.
Person you've ever met in your life.
Like
but he is so funny, just all the time. Damn. Just genuinely so funny.
Like, Bolin was like our favorite.
No, yeah. I also recognized him, PJ, from like other movies. I'd always seen him kind of in the background, like as like a secondary character.
Right.
And when I got to see him like kind of shine on that show, he was like one of like my favorite parts of it. So it was really cool to see him kind of transform.
Hard.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you go for Asami or did they place you?
I went for Korra originally.
Really?
And got called back for Asami. Yeah. Oh. Actually, Asami was originally going to be evil.
She looked like she wears the color red.
Yeah. Because I remember when I got the part, Brian and Mike were telling me, yeah, it's like this evil girl, and then later they were like, no, we didn't dig that. Like she meshes with everyone real well. I think like a little bit as we got into the show.
That's incredible.
Cool.
Yeah,
oh my god.
I want to trade with you. I wish one episode
you'd
I could have done
Asami.
You'd
probably be much better at it than me.
I could do Asami.
Oh,
I want to do Asami.
You want to
do
Asami?
Why not?
We should do
one episode.
We should do that.
I think we should do that.
Let's redub it.
I think we should do that.
Let's redub it.
You're gonna get sued or something.
Yeah. Can you redub for me?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, that'd be so crazy.
I always wanted to cosplay
all four seasons
as an airbender. I always wanted to cosplay, but then I realized I don't like putting on costumes.
Why?
I know you love putting on costumes.
You have a glittery glove on.
See, this is real life for me. This is not a costume. This is me being myself.
Oh, okay. this is real.
That's what people in costumes say.
Yo, yeah.
Just saying.
That's who you are.
I love costumes.
Oh my
God.
Can we talk about our best costumes? Just basically,
please,
I'm going to brag about my best costume, which was the best costume. I was Gandhi one year for Halloween. I put a bald cap on, and I had glasses and a mustache, and I went to Little India in Vancouver, and this Indian woman taught me how to tie my little diaper, and like, I looked so legit, and I got so drunk, and Gandhi passed out next to the girl from Pulp Fiction with the thing in her chest. Me and her were passed out on the same bed.
I want you to take a look at that.
Yeah, it's important.
It's real.
That's
real.
Him.
What? That's me as Gandhi.
Yeah.
Shut coincidence? The fuck that's
up.
A coincidence. That's right?
I'm not supposed
to. No, you can say fucking shit and bitch, but.
That is so funny.
Yeah, I had to.
That's
Gandhi.
Intense.
Gandhi. When
that's
I grew up,
amazing.
Gandhi was my hero.
Yeah.
I'm so glad you did.
We have
that.
A giant portrait in our house
of him.
It's a giant poster.
Right?
Awesome. Yeah.
You brought it to the new house?
Yeah, I had to. I've had that since I was probably 16. It's all ripped and whatnot.
Get it framed.
It's in a thing. It's in some wood.
Yeah.
Have you guys heard the soundtrack from the movie? I mean, I'm sure if you've seen the movie, you've heard the soundtrack.
I love the movie.
It's such a good soundtrack. Yeah.
I was surprised by that movie, honestly, because I watched it when I had to watch it for school, in high school. Mm-hmm. I was like, ugh.
It's like 3 hours
long.
That movie is boring as fuck, but I loved it.
Wait, you think it's boring?
I mean, I loved it.
Ben Kingsley is amazing.
I watched it by myself.
It's great for something you watch in school, but like at that age, I never would have watched it myself. But like as a school thing, it was really, really engaging.
Mm-hmm. I was 17 and watched it right before I went to college. Like I had like a week or something before I went to film school, and I was like, oh, I'll watch some films, and I love Gandhi. And I was like, I was like awed by it. But like there was a lot of talking. Gandhi likes to do that talking stuff, but
a lot of talking, a lot of silence too. A lot of silence. Yeah.
A lot of walking.
A lot of extras.
A lot of extras.
So many extras. That was like an old school, like, big-ass production.
That's a big movie. They didn't CGI people in the back. Mm-hmm. Those are real. Like, they're part about Gandhi's funeral. The movie, I think, starts and ends with Gandhi's funeral. And what they did is that, like, they put posters around everybody, all around wherever that was, New Delhi or something. They said, we're going to remake Gandhi's funeral for a movie. And it was just incredible.
And they got that's how they sourced all those extras?
They got all those people. That's and Ben Kingsley's dead in the middle. So.
Jeez. Wait, what's your best costume?
Yes.
Oh man, my best costume. This is tough. Lum.
Huh?
Probably Lum from Invader Lum. She's like the skankiest thing alive. It's like a 70s. It's like an old school 70s anime, and she's wearing like leopard print. She's wearing tiger print. And
I've seen that.
Yeah.
When I went 160 weeks into your Instagram.
Thanks. Yeah. That's like actually the picture.
Yeah.
Yes.
I bet it is.
I'm posing with like a Lady BMO.
Yeah.
BMO.
From Adventure Time.
Adventure Time.
All right. Whatever your gray suit is, that's your best. No.
Wait, my morph suit?
Morph suits.
That's not a costume.
That's my best costume. For this
what
past Comic-Con, we did the sketch, and I had to be a person from the future, and it was just a dumb bit where I panned my face silver with paint that shouldn't have been on my face.
Oh, no.
That was my own fault.
It's stuck in his hair still.
And in your pores.
Yeah, a little, maybe. But then I wore this bodysuit, and they put me in like a little UFO flying around. But my favorite costume is, okay, she helped me put it together. It was for this year's Comic-Con. I wanted to be the Flash really bad, like really bad. So she helped me find some places to look on the internet for it. Mm-hmm. I got a design, I got it printed, got someone to sew it together. So I had a full Flash bodysuit for Comic-Con.
And you looked good.
Thank you.
That's incredible.
And there was shading for muscles, and it made me look really good.
What's
up? Like, on picture, that was on point. It was
thank
beautiful.
You. My butt looked great. Phil put it on his Snapchat. My boss put it on his Snapchat. My butt looked great.
I that's saw that butt.
It was a good butt.
You had rippling muscles on your butt.
Yeah, now if you look at it, you don't know what's there.
Yeah.
A football butt.
Football players have the best butts.
Hey.
Maybe it's the shiny pants.
Are you a method actor?
Am I a method actor?
Are you a method
that's
actor?
A super out of nowhere question.
I want to know.
Sometimes. Not all the time.
Not too deep in. I hear like people do crazy things for it.
Sometimes, yeah. I mean, I've done characters who, characters who like certain things a lot. I surround myself with those things.
Really? What if you don't like it? You just got to make yourself like it?
Well, you got to find the things within it that you can kind of relate to. I don't know. It's vague.
What's so crazy about method acting? Like, doesn't it kind of make sense? Like, you kind of surround yourself.
It kind of seems
stuff.
Crazy.
Oh, I do, huh?
A little.
Yeah. I
right?
do.
Like,
I do the
kind
same
of like
thing.
A part of
yeah, I surround myself only with comedy. Everything else is like, I don't want to hear about it. Like,
except
that's why
Kanye.
I don't watch it.
Except for Kanye.
Except for Kanye. Because Kanye, okay, here's my thing about Kanye. Kanye West and Chris Rock are the same guy. They talk about the same stuff.
I feel you.
But when you say it like this, it's funny. But when you say, stop all that coon shit, it's like bad. But when Chris Rock says, stop all that coon shit, I'm sorry, can I say that? Like, that one might not be okay.
Oh, no.
That one might not be okay.
Oh, like, Will.
Sorry about that.
Why it's
a lyric.
Stopping us?
You can say a lyric, right?
Hey.
You're quoting. It's a quote.
It's a quote.
There you
you guys have bleeps?
Nah.
Yeah, there's some.
No. Oh, man. We'd have to pay him $100,000 a year. That is too much work.
Yeah. No, method acting is crazy. Like, who's the biggest one? Who's the biggest guy?
Daniel Day-Lewis.
Yeah.
There you go.
What did he even do?
How do you method act for Lincoln? Like, when there's cars. Every, like, you
know.
Must go out to the country
like, you
and
have to
not have
the
any
beer.
Electricity.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, you churn
weed,
your cheese.
Did Lincoln smoke weed?
I heard that Lincoln puffed a little bit. Yeah.
I'd buy it.
No, I bet he was like, all right.
Thomas Jefferson did.
Listen,
like, so
did
let's
he really?
Free the slave.
He had a hemp farm.
All right.
Wait, Watson, do you guys see Dazed and Confused?
No.
And that's like one of my favorite movies. And the stoner's like, yeah, man, like George Washington's wife always had a big ass bowl waiting for him when he got home. It's like my favorite line in the movie.
Yeah,
it's true.
George Washington did grow hemp plants, I heard.
Yeah.
So you think he wasn't rolling it up?
Yeah. He had like farms and farms.
But hemp farms.
Hemp farms.
Hemp. Hemp.
You know
makes
he
it
knew.
Sound more official.
Someone caught it
for
on
a
fire.
President.
Like, that's not good.
Yeah. Didn't you tell me like that the Aztecs used to, they didn't know what weed was, or like the Mayans, one of the Aztecs, somebody, they didn't know
like
what weed was.
Hallucinogenics and stuff like that.
So they would put themselves in a room and smoke it all and like hotbox it, and then they would like go crazy.
See God, yeah.
Yeah, they would see God,
like spiritual moments, yeah.
Wait, what's the hallucinogenic like, thing you drink, like you pass it around.
Peyote?
Peyote! Like that?
Ayahuasca.
Probably that sounds about right.
Yeah.
Hey, I just heard about a new crazy hallucinogenic. It's called, it's like three letters, and it sounds like the scariest thing in the world. You experience your birth and your death.
Oh,
and
I have heard of this.
Sounds,
oh my gosh!
It's like DMT. Something like that? I don't know.
DMT's
sounds,
been around.
That's crazy.
I'm sorry.
DMT's
I don't know
around.
My drugs. Sorry.
Experience your life and your...
Your birth and your life.
Okay.
Yeah. Something like that.
That
I
sounds
don't know.
Fun.
Yeah, does it?
No. If you have a good
no.
life.
No, it doesn't sound life. Fun. Nope.
Oh, boy. They're giving me the signal over there.
Like, okay,
don't do that anymore.
Yeah.
Best believe, Sophia, I was going to go on for another 20 minutes.
sorry.
Coming over here bringing us naughty thoughts.
I'm
but
not a good
person.
No one had ever said peyote in this room until then.
I, you know what? I learned peyote from the show Weeds, not
Weeds.
From real life. So,
not
because
to brag.
Nancy sipped peyote. Didn't she?
Did she?
I
only know the Tiki Taki song in the beginning.
I've never seen anything. Any movie you ever bring up, any show you've ever bring
unless
up.
Unless it's anime.
Unless it's anime. And really only like three of them.
No, it's that's not true. You've watched a
or
lot.
Or Spider-Man.
I've watched
I'm
you
proud of
a
you.
Lot.
Spider-Man.
Oh,
Spider-Man.
I can't watch. I'm done with Spider-Man.
Why?
No, you're not.
What?
You're not done
why
with Spider-Man.
Done with
wait, why? Were you invested in Andrew Garfield?
No, I liked Spider-Man too much. Like, right before I liked Avatar too much, and it which I thought about it too much. Now
really?
I think about Kanye a lot.
Oh. You're about to get too much Kanye.
Yeah.
What
I actually
happens?
Had told myself I need to stop listening to Kanye, so I went back to Drake.
Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Yeah. Because I listen to Kanye and I get mad at people.
You're good at
do you
toddling.
Like Drake?
Or do I? Who doesn't like Drake? Or, you don't like
to be fair,
like
he's talented. He's great. But when somebody plays him 24/7.
On blast.
Wow. That's my roommate as well.
Oh, yeah.
My
you
roommate.
Still
hang out with your roommate.
Plays Drizzy like right when she wakes up.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
No.
Yes.
And I'm not like that, but I I enjoy it. Yeah.
At first, I was like, yeah. And then it's like 3 months later, and you're like, with my woes. Yeah.
I moved away from your room, so I can appreciate it for what it is now. Yeah. I'm not annoyed by it whatsoever.
We also live together, so when I go home.
That's a different
story. Not just me. It is also Darren.
So there's two different Drake songs playing at the same time in two different parts of the house. And then you come to work, and you're in the same room playing the same song, synchronized.
Yeah, that's a nightmare. I understand.
I mean, remember when Guardians of the Galaxy came out and I heard, hooked on the feeling. Nobody liked that song before that.
No
and
one
if
knew
did,
that
it was
song.
In the 80s.
I don't even know that song.
You know from the movie? The one that he plays in the beginning?
You didn't see Guardians?
You didn't see LaGuardians of the Galaxy?
No, I didn't. I didn't.
You were alive.
Shame me.
No, we won't shame you.
I'll take it. I'll take it.
God,
it's just one of my
favorite
movies of all time.
Is it actually?
Yes.
You think that one is it?
Yes, it's
really?
one of them.
I see.
Yeah, I still have better.
It's
movies.
That good?
Oh, yeah, I loved it. It's really good.
Cool.
It's got good emotion.
It's a Marvel movie.
Yeah,
and it's gonna get tied in, which is kind of crazy.
Yeah, it's gonna be real
you
cool.
Dang
no, it's they take five of the most pointless characters in comic books and make them lovable.
The
and
most pointless,
like,
yeah.
A raccoon and a talking tree.
So this is like way more rewarding if you come into it with a background in comics, right?
Maybe. I didn't know about the characters.
No, but you said the characters came from other things. Am I...
Oh, they'll be tied
track.
Into other movies, which is going to be
the
really
cool. Oh, okay, so they're new characters.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, never mind. Yeah.
They're just
no.
not popular.
Yeah.
There you go. That's
They've
the best way.
They've existed in time already, mm-hmm. but now they're becoming popular.
And everybody in the movie theater pretends like they knew. Like, I remember Groot from,
Impossible.
My favorite part of comic book movies is, like, after, like, the credits roll, like, after the Avengers, there's this big purple guy, and everyone's like, oh, they picked that guy, and like, oh, my God, I love him. No one can name his name. No one knows who he is, everything. And they're like, oh, he's Thanos. Oh, we know Thanos. He's being, a Spider-Man fought, and, like, they don't know anything. Comic book nerds always, comic book nerds pretend to know a lot.
Spider-Man
they pretend.
Never fought Thanos.
He maybe did.
They do anything they want.
Yeah, they
books.
Do whatever
yeah.
they want.
Anything they want. Uh-huh. And Spider-Man, last year, Peter Parker died. Dr. Octopus put his brain inside of his
this
body.
Is this a comic book?
Yeah.
Comic
book.
No,
I'm
real life.
Not reading
oh,
comic
wait,
books.
I know this
inside
one.
Inside of Peter Parker's
body?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's frightening. It's nuts.
And
yeah.
he lived, and then he found out he liked being Spider-Man, so he stopped doing evil shit and was doing Spider-Man better than Spider-Man was doing Spider-Man.
Even though he's Doc Ock.
Even though he's Doc Ock.
But Peter Parker was still in his brain, so he took over his brain later.
He took over his brain.
Spoilers, buddy.
He was still evil.
He was still evil and good.
Even
I don't
if
know.
He was saving people because his brain was in somebody else's body.
Yeah.
Comic books are too That's much.
Evil. No, I was talking to DJ. He's one of our editors here, and he loves comic books. He's talking about how comic books, there's not a lot invested in them. So people can take bigger risks with, like, crazier stories. Like,
you can
erase, like, a whole universe and bring it back together because God snapped his fingers.
Right,
and,
right.
And
you
know,
can
like,
explain
what?
It away with all these superpowers
yeah.
anyway.
Right.
Aunt May got shot in Spider-Man once.
Yeah.
And then in order to fix that, Spider-Man went to the devil, Mephisto, in Marvel, the devil's called
Mephisto.
Mephisto.
Yeah,
seriously?
That's a great name.
And then what did he ask him for?
He said, we can save her life if you sell your marriage to me because all that
what?
Potential love that you had between you and your wife, I'm going to eat off that.
So he wasn't
what?
Married to Mary Jane anymore.
So what,
it was.
How do you eat someone's love?
It's comics.
It's comics.
I don't know. I don't know.
Supposed to be in the writer's room for this?
Yeah.
It must be insane. So they're like, all right.
It's got
to
be
so what if he didn't do that?
Yeah.
No.
What if we took everything and then just shat on it? So, and then nerds get real mad.
Yeah.
Are you giving me the signal again? That means don't do that one. So Barack Obama.
Oh, my God. Michelle Obama was in my dream last night. She actually saved my life.
She would.
It was really nice. I had cancer. I think I dreamed this because I went to the record store last night. My cashier remembered me because I was an Aries and he was a Cancer. I don't know. It was strange. And then I went to sleep and I had cancer, but the government said because I had this type of cancer, they would have to kill me.
Uh-oh.
And
oh, my
like,
God.
Yeah, they'd have to give me this drug that maybe like 5% of people survive, which my dad had survived in this dream. And I was like crying. I was like, I don't want to take this drug. Like, I don't want to die. And the government's like, you have to. And my parents, everyone, my dad was like playing the flute to try to make me feel better. It was really strange. And then at the end, we were all at like this luncheon, and my brother was there, and he was like feeling for me, and like all of, you know, these like family friends were there. And then we turn around, someone's like, look who showed up. Michelle Obama's here. I was like, Michelle.
Her arms are going to save you.
Yeah, I was like, Michelle. And I was like, can you change these laws? I don't want to die. She's like, yeah, I can help you. And we all started crying, and I woke up. It was so weird.
You know
that
she can't change any laws at all, right? You know she has no political power.
I know, but but she could talk to Barack.
Her arms.
I think Barack would like my family.
That's so interesting though, because you seem like the most mellow person in the world. You listen to blues music.
I mean, I have a reoccurring theme of people trying to kill me in my dreams.
What?
This is really intense.
Why?
I want to hear.
I just talked to my friend today about this because she's like, I have a reoccurring thing of people dying. Like, she thought her sister died, her boyfriend died, and she's like, I think that means maybe I'm, you know, somewhat afraid of people leaving me. Mm. And I was like, well, I think I'm afraid of what people think. And like, if I fail, you know, I mean, this is a human, very human thing, but I'm always afraid people are like going to come after me or like tell me I'm terrible for. I don't know.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. Well, that makes
afraid
sense.
Of failure is pretty normal.
That's what I think those people like. I've been in dreams where there'd been like actors groups I've been a part of that all turned out to be like murderers.
Okay, right. That's a really extreme turn.
That's crazy.
I mean, okay.
So
it's like you suck at acting and then that you're afraid that they're going to kill you.
I mean, that's a very intense jump.
You think this is crazy? How many people would you say, you know, just guess, how many people do you know?
How many people do I know?
Yeah, in your life.
Like acquaintances?
Yeah, just people you know.
No.
Probably like 300 or 400.
No. Yeah, hundreds of people.
How is it possible that not one of them is a murderer? One of them's got to be a murderer.
That's a really scary thought.
One of them. He just hasn't done it yet, Zach.
Maybe by accident.
Don't be looking like that.
No, I thought about that at Comic-Con because I'm like, there's 400,000 people at Comic-Con. One of these people has had
okay,
to
that's like
murder
more
someone.
Like 100 of them probably.
Maybe.
That's a lot.
That's maybe.
Okay, with that many people, crazy. There's one person up in there. You can go up to him and say, hey, let's do peyote in the bathroom, and he'll do it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, at Comic-Con? Yeah.
At Comic-Con. I'm sorry. I'm done. I won't mention it again.
We set up a theme by accident.
Yeah.
But murderers are A-okay.
Why?
To talk about.
Cool yeah. It's when you get specific. We're saying murderer instead of guy who cuts your foot off and feeds it to his dog. That's
right,
different.
Right.
There's definitely that guy at Comic-Con.
Yeah. There's definitely that guy.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Where they feed limbs to other things.
They have to. There has to be that guy.
I guess. I mean, it's, yeah.
There
how else do you dispose
be.
Of it, right?
I don't know. That's like a very, very
specific.
Lone person, I feel like, in like thousands of people. I think that's a very...
I don't
400,000 people
yeah.
among
all,
them.
All you guys have been in Comic-Con except me. I know that because I was like Twitter stalking you and like typed it on YouTube. What's it like?
It's a sea of mess, you sad man.
It's insane.
Is it sad?
It's actually insane. Are we talking about San Diego Comic Con?
Oh, yeah. Even other ones?
It's insane. Yeah, I've been to WonderCon.
Oh, okay, cool.
Is that in the Bay Area?
Oh, no, WonderCon's
here. No, that's
here.
In Anaheim.
Yeah,
oh,
it's here
yeah.
now.
Going to
it
Sacramento.
Used to be in San Fran, yeah.
WonderCon.
And then MCM in London, which that one's awesome.
How was it? What's that like
small.
For you?
Going it's to awesome. A... It's super easy.
Does everyone recognize you?
No.
Really?
No.
Oh, that's surprising.
No, because it's a voice. Well, you know.
I guess so.
If you spoke up a little bit.
They would know.
They'd swarm.
But I guess people, like the Comic-Con crowd is very like internet heavy. Mm. So a lot of them do, I guess,
right.
recognize
exactly.
us from that.
And Princess Yue.
True.
Right?
Very true. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No.
I don't even want to talk about...
Yeah, we can let that one slide.
Yeah. No.
Let's go to the next point.
I want to say that was the first time I ever saw you, and I was like, oh, my God,
an
this is amazing.
An angel has descended
I'm
from
not,
heaven.
I know it's weird to say it to you in person, but I was like, what? Who is this? Then that was the first time I Googled you, and I did 11 more times over the next 4 years.
Yeah. Wait, even 11, better. Yeah, 11.
To be exact.
This is actually kind of cool. Somebody went
What'd
to... What, you went to, like, a pre-screening of it or something? Or no, you went to, like, the first showing or something? Of the Avatar
movie?
No,
that
movie?
Was the SpongeBob movie that he
that
went to.
That was the SpongeBob
no
movie.
No way.
Yeah, that was the
didn't
SpongeBob
you watch one or the second one?
The first one.
Okay, the first one was great. I didn't see
good.
The second one.
Second one's okay. I watched it recently.
I need to go see it.
I had
it.
A sad Saturday. I wanted to feel better, so I watched SpongeBob.
So you went to
Did
see SpongeBob?
No, I didn't go see. I watched it in my room.
In normal adult terms, that's a sad Saturday. But for people like you and I, that's
it's
not
it's
that.
It's a
pretty banging Saturday.
SpongeBob is amazing.
It's amazing.
Amazing.
It's a
best cartoon.
It's really messed up. It's weird sometimes.
It's kind of fucked up.
Yeah.
It's actually, but it's really smart.
It's
like,
smart.
And
yeah.
even their banter, like if you really listen to it, mm-hmm. they're saying kind of important stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's kind of creepy, actually.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah. All cartoons are. I feel like the writers have to like kind of like mask like more serious
Like everything is actually right. creepypasta.
Do you
oh, yeah.
Everything
you
actually has a back. Creepypasta is the site that like kind of has all the lore that. Plays on all the tropes that are occurring in the show. Kind of like,
cool.
what's a good one? Like, Rugrats is a really creepy one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So people come up with kind of like scary fan theories behind Rugrats. On Creepypasta, you find all of them there. Yeah. And they have every scary story you'd ever need to find. I go there sometimes when I can't sleep and I just want to be more scared.
And then you can't sleep more.
The Rugrats one is...
Yeah, it's terrifying. That one is like... Everything is actually Angelica's hallucination, and it's all in her head.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, like, the twins. Nope. And, like, the creepy example is, like, the one that scared me was Phil and Lil are identical twins because the mom had an abortion or something, she actually didn't know the gender, so she had to create it in her mind. That's why she couldn't choose what gender they were, which is why they're identical twins.
And Dill, the Tommy's little brother, was the only real baby, and she didn't know how to cope with having a real baby, so she, like, attacked him, and that's why he's all messed up.
I think somebody had a sad weekend, and they're like, what could I make up?
How could I ruin everyone's childhood?
Yeah.
And dark.
Yeah. So dark and convoluted. Wow.
The one that's really cool is the Pixar fan theory, because it's not sad and dark. Yeah. It just makes it everything's in one big world. It's really nice.
Oh,
it makes you feel good.
All the movies?
Yes. Yeah, it's really sweet.
There are parts of it that are kind of hard to follow. You have to, like, remember everything.
Every detail.
Yeah, as you're reading it. But if you can, it's really cool. Mm-hmm. It's very interesting.
Did you guys see Inside Out?
Yes.
Yes. Did you see it?
Oh, no.
Did you like it?
Yes, I loved it.
Oh, boy. Sam, I was disappointed by it.
Oh.
Brandy, you don't like anything.
No, that is not true.
All right.
She loves a lot of things, and I don't know her. it seems like she loves many things.
I don't think most people don't know Raina. Like, I know Raina. Hey. Raina, as soon as you press cut, when Raina gets her blazer on and turns to business Raina.
Business Raina's a different story, okay? Business Raina is different, and that's not fair, because normal Raina is very happy.
Raina's very happy.
Yeah. Normal Raina's very nice. Stuff.
Why were you disappointed?
I was disappointed by how purely I did not enjoy sadness. I cannot believe how annoyed I was by one character. Usually in Pixar, they have a lot of dimensions where it's like, yeah, they're quite annoying, but there's something about them that's so redeeming and perfect and fantastic about them that they fit the part correctly. Like, they're the correct link in the chain. Mm-hmm. She was so annoying to me. I couldn't handle it. And Joy was so phenomenal and perfect, but mostly because it's...
Amy Poehler.
Yeah, but it's Amy Poehler, but then in my mind, it's like Leslie Knope, so it's even better. I didn't enjoy the ending. I forgot specifically what I wanted to happen, but I had this buildup for, like, what I believe should happen. I think it was something like... they all realize that you need sadness, because without sadness, she doesn't realize that all this, like, backlash is happening. Sorry, spoilers. Mm-hmm. That all this backlash is happening. So after she makes a move, she realizes that sadness is needed, or, like, this bad emotions are needed just as much as the good emotions. Mm-hmm. But before anything bad happened, the ending happened. And I didn't like that. I wanted
something bad
to be the
almost
conflict.
Happened. I enjoyed it because there were things that happened in the movie that made me tear up. There weren't, like, intentional, like, tugs at
the
your heartstrings. The talking volcano. Oh,
that's
Steve was
all
talking
I know.
About that.
Everybody came back and was like, "You see this talking volcano shit?" No. God.
That's the whole that short so based bad. On it, the dumbest pun ever. It's called
what?
The song is.
That's not even from
someone,
the movie?
That's
it's
from
it's
the short.
It's a short film right before the movie.
Find someone to lava.
Oh.
Sorry, puns really hurt
me.
Oh,
that's what that is.
It's just a big pun. It's a big pun.
I'm sorry, mind blown. I like it more now. Not gonna lie, I like it even more now.
I enjoyed it. I thought it was funny though. I didn't cry.
It was sad.
Yeah. I thought it was so funny.
What, the movie?
The Inside Volcano.
The Volcano, the short. Oh, best short, if you guys can remember this, is... The dog? Not the dog.
Oh,
my favorite is no, not the chess one. The one with the paper airplanes. You know, it won an Academy Award like 2 years ago. Oh. It was about it's like Jim and Pam from The Office, basically. You guys don't know what I'm talking about.
I do. I remember.
It's really
good.
You should look it up. It's like Paper Man.
Look it up.
It's
really
good.
All the other
it's so
things.
Sweet.
I like
a million
the dog
things.
One the most.
I've been writing a list. Don't worry.
Great.
Yeah, you're welcome.
The dog one was my favorite.
The dog one.
We're very similar.
There's a dog. It's in his perspective, and the owner is always feeding him different stuff, and then he finds out that he's feeding him different food, and that's because he's like not getting divorced, but like he broke up with his girlfriend and stuff. Mm. It's you'd like it, Will. You would enjoy that short.
Oh, he's busy.
You're busy
listening
to Kanye.
You think Kanye goes to Pixar?
Yes.
Yeah.
He's got a kid.
Yeah,
totally.
Of course, he's going to Pixar.
There were these photos that came out recently where Kanye West and Kim Kardashian bought out a Disneyland for a day for their baby, which is like 2 years
for
old.
Their
what?
Baby
okay.
Ever.
Like, okay, if you need to be at least 20 years old to appreciate that. Uh-huh. Do you know how goddamn expensive that is? But what he did during that, they watched Frozen, and Kanye's like looking at Frozen.
Hey, in that
Kanye
one interview,
Frozen and I didn't.
In that one interview, he
I haven't
snapped.
Seen Frozen either.
Whoa!
What's that? Whoa! First person I've met. That was terrible.
Yeah, I just
I had to aim. Yeah.
You're supposed to look at your elbows.
I've heard that.
But no, he in an interview he snapped and he compared himself to the glitch in Wreck-It Ralph. Like he says, "I'm a glitch." You've never seen
that? He does a lot of movie references.
Yeah.
He talked
so
about...
So he watches Disney.
What's that That's movie where yeah. Will Ferrell plays basketball?
Oh, it's an awful... He talked about that movie at all.
He was like, it's like that movie. Like,
yeah. I missed
what?
That one.
Which one?
It's something semi-pro. I think
semi-pro.
It's
semi-pro.
Oh.
Yeah.
Will Ferrell?
Will Ferrell. Mm-hmm. It's one of the Will Ferrell movies that happened.
He also, in the song, I think New Slaves, he says, "I'm going Bobby Boucher." I'm like, he watches some movies.
Yeah.
From Waterboy.
That's what it is. That's what it is. Okay. Adam Sandler, huh?
Wow, he's a lot more clever than I thought. I'm
when you're
sad
mean,
now.
When you're mean, you don't have a lot of friends, so you have to watch movies.
What's your favorite Adam Sandler movie?
8 Crazy Nights. Oh. I'm just kidding.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Deeds is good. I made you happy.
Yes, you did.
Wait, what's the dad one?
Big Daddy.
Big Daddy.
That's mine.
Yeah.
That's my
Big
favorite.
That's a good one. 50 First Dates is also really good.
I've only seen a few scenes from when Little Nicky. And like I've only seen the part where he's like asleep and he's like, "I'm a gay live human" or some shit like that. And I thought that was real funny, but I haven't seen
the
movie.
Mm-hmm.
I was busy. Funny.
You got really sad when I said 8 Crazy Nights.
Yeah, because
is it animated?
Yeah, it is. You don't like Whitey?
Wait. Did Adam Sandler make an animated movie with himself animated into it?
Yeah, he's the main character.
That's genius.
Did he write it?
I'm doing that
it
next.
Seems
is
like
that
one
a
of his
Christmas
movies.
Movie?
Yes,
yes. It's a
holiday.
I think it's a Hanukkah.
Wait.
It's a
Hanukkah movie. Yeah.
Okay, never mind.
Mm-hmm.
What?
What's the one with the Scrooge?
Is that Jim Carrey?
That's Jim Carrey.
Yeah. Okay,
Jim
that
Carrey.
One was good. Okay, yeah.
It was good.
I haven't seen that one.
I liked it. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I don't really have a high standard for things. I mean, movies, which I should, but I don't.
Everybody's different.
I don't have a high standard
for things.
I love it.
Yeah, you can quote that.
I will.
I'm really smart.
Yeah.
Can I ask you to do something? Is this really rude? Do you remember any lines from Korra? And can you sound like a zombie?
You nerd.
I know. I just want to hear one thing.
To be fair,
do you know how hard it was to get her in here?
I know.
And you
I'm
ask
sorry.
Her this.
I'm ruining it. Well, you know, we're coming up on time, so I thought now might be.
They don't bring you to other places and say some Japanese stuff. Oh, yeah,
yes, they do.
Wait, hold on. That's the whole
thing. It just happened.
Yeah. We're horrible.
It just occurred. Yeah. So
do some Asami shit.
Or you could just say Korra's name.
People have been telling me on Twitter that because Janet did this thing at a convention where she proposed to Asami, so maybe this would be the right opportunity. Okay, I'm not. How do I get into this?
get into character.
I don't know. It's not very far from my. wow. Yes.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I could cry.
There you go. Thank you so much.
I remember when that came out, when the last episode came out, all three of us were like, especially Raina,
we
was just like,
together.
Oh my God.
I
How does that
so
feel
happy.
To know that you had your voice acting had that impact on people?
That It's so really weird. People, we yeah. got this book, this Reddit book, and I don't really know anything about Reddit.
Me
I
either.
Still don't, and it kind of makes me scared.
I knew too much about it.
Yeah, but... we got this book, Janet got them, and then sent them to me, Brian, and Mike, where all these people on Reddit, on this message board, had written letters to us about the impact of Korrasami on Aww. Their lives. And going through this book was very emotional.
Yeah.
I'd never...
That episode was a game changer.
Yeah.
Like, truly.
It was
TV.
So beautiful.
In Nickelodeon.
Now gay marriage is legal.
Because of that.
Because of that.
Thank you, Korra.
Uh-huh. Thanks, Korra, Nickelodeon.
That was really, really a cool thing to experience, that your art, you know.
Yeah.
That is really cool.
If they ever do another, like, reboot type of thing, would you join in again?
Oh, are you kidding me?
Of course you would.
Kidding me. Yeah.
Why'd you get short?
I just felt like it.
Okay.
I was, like, always hoping they'd
let
me do it. You
get short if you want.
How do you...
There's a thing on the
side. See, I did it to be different, you know.
No, but
now
we don't like that.
I'm different.
Yes, I'm different. Pull up to the scene with your silly missing. Pull up.
That's a song I don't know. All
right. Sam and I are like 2 Chainz.
No,
Mustard on the beat, ho.
Oh,
can I be honest with you? The last podcast we did, I wanted to start off by saying Mustard on the beat, ho, but I was like, that would be inappropriate, and she just made me because it's a part of the
she
song.
She made you.
She made you.
Yeah, that's nice.
On the record, Seychelle made Will say Mustard on the beat, ho.
Oh, can you please say Mustard on the beat, ho, again?
Mustard on, is it the beat?
On the beat.
Ho.
Ho.
Oh.
Ho.
How different is your voice from Asami's voice?
I don't think it's that different.
It sounds pretty similar.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I've maybe, that's why I was a little tentative, dude. I don't remember as much where the placement was. I think it was more in a higher, a little more dynamic to it. I don't know.
That's a really cool way of thinking about like speaking and delivering lines.
Yeah, like dynamic
lines. That's
voices.
Really cool because I used to do singing too, and like I know like placement.
Yeah, yeah.
Like
it's like where you feel it kind of. Yeah. It's a.
I do that.
Theater thing almost.
That's
yeah.
Cool.
You were a theater kid too, huh?
Oh yeah, Sam was a good big one. Theater kid.
I was in theater class too, and I remember one time, my friend and I, my best friend Jose and I, had to remember a scene, and I did not remember the scene because you know I'm an asshole. And I remember I went out there, and then I remember the beginning, and I did not remember the rest, so I just said jokes, and everybody thought it was funny, and then I left. I mean, I didn't leave, I just walked off, and I was like, and that was probably my first time doing stand-up comedy.
That was your first time doing games. Yeah.
I'm a theater kid too.
Yeah.
Somewhere.
Theater kids
are awesome.
Oh yeah.
Sometimes they scared
nerds,
me.
I'm awesome. Not a theater kid. The only thing I've ever done was Annie.
Annie?
Yeah. That's
were you Annie?
No. No, I'm Asian. That doesn't make any sense.
Asian Annie.
Thank you. Yeah. Oh. It's Annie.
Anizo.
Anizo. Oh my God. No, I was Tessie, the one that always said, oh my goodness, they're fighting and I can't sleep all night.
Look.
Oh, you remember all right. Your lines?
I do.
Like
that's
sometimes,
so cute.
It's weird.
Sometimes, like, you know, upwards of 100,000 people watch this. I will pay any amount of money for a videotape of Raina and Annie.
Oh my
there's got to be somebody with a sound bite or something.
Have it.
You have
it? I have it. I'm
and
VHS.
You never
we need a VHS
this up?
Player.
I have it.
What are those called?
VHS.
I don't know.
You want to see it?
Yes.
Yeah, you can't take it. You can't take it like you took
can't
all my
take
child
it
photos.
With you.
Well, they're nice.
Hey, we didn't take them. You brought them in the office for
everybody. Hey. No, that's not true.
I know, that's not true at all. That's not true. Even a little bit, even remotely. Her baby picture's all over the office for some reason.
That's awesome.
Yeah, and it's signed by
him. Baby
cutest
pictures.
Baby. Cutest baby.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But guys, I think that's it for the podcast today. It's near 5 o'clock. I think we got to call it quits, but thank you so much for coming
cool.
on.
Well, thank you for
thank
having
you.
Me.
It's been really awesome time. Thank you so much.
And we made history. She said yes to Cora.
I did.
She
I'm
yes
sorry.
On our
I
podcast.
On SourceFed podcast.
Nervous.
What's that like, knowing that you've been talked about on here before?
A lot.
By
a
him,
lot.
Mainly.
A lot.
By
a lot.
Him, mainly.
It's fine. I don't, it's
it
not,
was
that,
so
it's not
chill.
That strange.
Does
it's,
anything make you
it's,
mad?
It's a little weird, but it's not, I mean, it kind of comes with the territory a little bit, right? I mean, everything's online, everything's so
everything's
media.
Everything's online.
A true professional.
Right now. Mm-hmm. I wanted to go full circle. I want that to happen to me, too.
It will one day.
Someday.
I promise you guys. And guys, if you like this podcast, please give it a thumbs up on YouTube and on iTunes. We surely appreciate it. Also, leave some comments on SoundCloud and on iTunes. And make sure you resubscribe and do all that thing. And thank you to Crunchyroll for sponsoring this.
Yes, thank you
finger.
So much.
Excited to watch.
And
Seychelle,
where can we
current.
Find you?
On Twitter. That's my only public thing.
What's your at?
Seychelle Gab. SeychelleGab.
Got any movie coming out soon we could watch?
Oh, yeah. Independent movie called Slight. I don't know when it comes out, but it's awesome. It's about magic and drug dealing.
Ooh.
Yeah.
They go hand in
everything
hand.
Yeah. Everything we love in life.
Were any of the drugs peyote. I'm sorry.
No, I'm not gonna.
All right. On that note, don't forget to visit crunchyroll.com/sfpodcast to get your free trial. Thank you so much for watching.
Thank you guys. Goodbye.
What is a sender?
If you eat me, my sender.
Okay, so obviously it's a mammal or food or a edible.
Recently, when asked about her sexuality, she stated, "Google me, I'm not hiding."